Hello friends, this video on photosynthesis in higher plants part 3 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam.
So now the next set of experiments were performed by a scientist named Julius von Sachs. So what did he do? So this scientist Julius von Sachs, he wanted to know the detail about where the food gets prepared and in what form is the food prepared. So what did he do? He kept a plant in sunlight, because by this time it was known that only in presence of sunlight oxygen is released. So it was not that everybody knew that okay, the food is also getting prepared by the same process, but the scientists wanted to know more detail about this process by which oxygen is released from the green parts of the plant in presence of sunlight. So in order to have more knowledge on the same, this scientist Julius von Sachs, he kept the green plant under sunlight for quite some time. And then he tried to observe what is happening in the green part of the plant. So for example, the leaves. So what did he do? He observed the leaves even more minutely, and he found that in presence of sunlight, plants make food in the form of glucose, which is stored in the plant in the form of starch, which is a polysaccharide. And he also observed that this green part of the plant, that is for example this leaf, contains a pigment called chlorophyll. So this was again a very important conclusion. So this was again a new step altogether. So chlorophyll was a pigment which was present in the green part of the plant, and that is why everywhere it was seen that only the green parts release oxygen. So that significance of the green part was in the presence of a pigment called chlorophyll. So on studying the green part, for example, on studying the leaf further, it was found that this is how the cross-section of a dicot leaf looked like. And in this leaf, it was found that the mesophyll layer contained some organelles called chloroplasts. So this is how the chloroplast looked like. So this were the chloroplast, and these chloroplast contained chlorophyll. So chlorophyll was present here somewhere here in the chloroplast. Now we will talk about the structure of the chloroplast in a little later, and I'm sure all of you would have heard about the chloroplast cell organelle, which is present only in the plant cells. So they are not present in animal cells. So this was again an important conclusion by Julius von Sachs, that the green parts of the plant contain a pigment called chlorophyll, and this chlorophyll is present inside the cell organelle called chloroplast. Now it was also seen that in absence of sunlight, the starch disappeared. The starch which was stored in the plant, it gradually started to decrease and then it disappeared. Why? Because the starch which was prepared or which was synthesized in presence of light was used up in dark during carbon dioxide release or producing carbon dioxide release activity or carbon dioxide producing activity. So it was basically something like this, that suppose you prepare food in the morning, right? You prepare enough food in the morning that you don't have to prepare food again at night. So once you prepare it in the morning and then you keep eating the same food till night, so what will happen? Gradually the food which you had prepared in the morning will start to decrease in amount, and by night it will be over. So similarly it happens in case of plants. They prepare food in presence of sunlight, and when it is dark they are not able to prepare any more food, but the food which they prepared during sunlight, that is stored and that gets used. So gradually that stored food will disappear when it is dark. So Julius von Sachs found or concluded this very important thing. So food is prepared in the form of glucose. So what was the conclusion? Chlorophyll located in chloroplasts of plant cells help in this process, and this process is nothing but photosynthesis. So you see by now, whatever experiments we spoke about, whether it was Priestley's experiment or Ingenhouse experiment or Julius von Sachs experiment, so by now so many things were concluded. First was that oxygen is released from the plants. Now, when is oxygen released? In presence of sunlight, only from the green parts of the plant. Why only from the green parts of the plant? Because the green parts contain a pigment called chlorophyll, which helps in this process. And this process was nothing but photosynthesis, because in this process, glucose or food was also prepared in the form of glucose and it was stored in the form of starch. So now you see almost every bit of information which combines together to form the process of photosynthesis was known. So glucose is stored in the form of starch in plants. Next came up the Engelmann experiment. So the scientist named Engelmann, he wanted to know which part of the light is absorbed by plants during this process of photosynthesis. Because till now, the scientists have been talking about the process takes place only in presence of light. But Engelmann's question was, when you talk about light, light has a variety of wavelengths. Like when you talk about light, light is white light. So light has got all different segments of different wavelengths. For example, there is ultraviolet light, there is infrared radiation, there is visible light, there are microwaves. So there are different types of waves in that electromagnetic spectrum. You would have studied about the electromagnetic spectrum in your physics. So Engelmann's simple question was, which part of this electromagnetic spectrum or which section or which wavelength of the light is actually absorbed by the plant during the process of photosynthesis? Because the wavelength varies a lot if you compare the ultraviolet radiation with the infrared rays. There is a huge wavelength difference. So he was interested to know which part of that electromagnetic spectrum was being utilized for the process of photosynthesis. So what did he do for that? I mean, how was he experimenting in order to get this information? Okay, so what he did was he split the white light into its constituent colors using a prism. You would have studied all these things. When you pass white light through a prism, it gets divided into its constituent colors. So white light is actually comprised of all the rainbow colors: violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, and red. So he split the white light into its constituent colors using a prism. Now he illuminated green algae called cladophora in a suspension of aerobic bacteria. So he took some aerobic bacteria. Aerobic means oxygen. Those bacteria which needs oxygen. So they are oxygen loving bacteria. So he used this oxygen loving photosynthetic bacteria in this white light, which already got divided into its constituent colors, and we observed that most of the aerobic bacteria were accumulated in the red and blue region of the spectrum. So if you look at the spectrum, this is how it looks like. So when you pass white light through a prism, it gets divided into its constituent colors like this. So this process is known as dispersion. So you would have studied about it in your physics. So this is how he got the light. He used this light, and with this light he illuminated the algae which was in a suspension of bacteria. So there were a huge number of bacteria, and those bacteria were oxygen loving. So they love oxygen. So they tend to be in a region where there is more oxygen because they need oxygen for their survival. So this oxygen loving photosynthetic bacteria were used, and it was found that most of the bacteria, so these dots which you see here, these dots represent the bacteria. You see, most of the bacteria accumulated either in the blue region, so this is the blue region, and the red region. The accumulation of bacteria in the green and the yellow region is quite less. So more bacteria in the blue and red region. So what does it mean? It means more photosynthesis is taking place in the blue and the red region. Correct? That is what it means. Because those bacteria are oxygen loving photosynthetic bacteria. So wherever photosynthesis will take place, more oxygen will be released. So wherever more oxygen will be released, these bacteria will tend to be there. So that means more photosynthesis is taking place in the blue and the red region of the spectrum. So what was the conclusion? That the red or blue region of visible light are absorbed during the process of photosynthesis. Now one more thing, just now when I started this Engelmann experiment, I told you that the electromagnetic spectrum not only consists of visible light, it also consists of other wavelength radiations like the microwaves, the radio waves, the infrared radiation, ultraviolet radiation. So now please remember that for the process of photosynthesis, plants utilize only the visible light. And in visible light also, the red and the blue region of the visible light are absorbed mostly. However, there you can see very small concentration of bacteria in other regions as well, but primarily the blue and the red region. So the blue and red region of the visible light was absorbed. So when I say this region was absorbed, what I mean is the light of wavelengths which fall under this blue region and the red region, they are primarily absorbed for the process of photosynthesis to take place. So this was again another interesting conclusion by Engelmann in his experiment. So plants appear green because the green and the yellow colors are reflective. So now another important thing which we get to know from here. Now by this we knew that out of all these colors, mostly the blue and the red colors get absorbed. Now whichever color gets absorbed, that is taken in by the plants. Now whichever color is reflected, that is the color of the plant which we see. For example, let us suppose if we find, suppose you are wearing a red dress. Now if I am looking at the dress and I can see it red, that means the dress is reflecting the red color. So whichever color it will reflect, I'll be able to see it in that color. Because whichever it has absorbed, I cannot see that. Only the reflected color will come to my eyes and I'll be able to perceive that. So similarly in case of plants, they appear green because they absorb all other colors and they reflect green color. So here you can see very clearly that the blue and the red region are absorbed. So what is reflected? Mostly the green and the yellow region. Now green being more dominant than yellow, so plants mostly appear green. However, some plants also do appear yellow when they dry up or when the content of chlorophyll reduces. So plants appear green due to two reasons. One is that they contain chlorophyll, and chlorophyll is the pigment which actually help in absorbing the light of particular wavelength. So chlorophyll will absorb the blue region and the red region, so it will reflect mostly the green and the yellow. That is why the plants will appear mostly green. Sometimes it also appears yellow to orangish in color. So I hope this is clear. See, this is how we are actually gathering all information which will together lead to the discovery of photosynthesis. Thank you. Please visit www.examfear.com to watch more videos, attempt free online test, get free study material, find tutors and mentors. Thank you once again.